When I got in my 20s, I started thinking about my financial future a whole lot more. That's when life started to change for me in ways that I haven't experienced before this point. Starting to pay bills and thinking about starting a family at some point. Things that as kids, we just wasn't thinking about. That was just a thought that was like, all right, yeah, that's gonna happen in 30 years or something like that. And I could tell you, at 25, only being in my 20s for 5 years now, I made a lot of money mistakes that I learned that most people should probably avoid in your 20s. We just gonna go ahead and get straight into it. So make sure y'all go ahead and hit like down below and also go ahead and subscribe because it's the neighbor button right next to it, and let's get it. Now the first money mistake that everybody in their 20s needs to avoid right now is not investing. I'm just like y'all. Investing was not a thing that was talked about heavily around me growing up, and even if it was, there was no real roadmap. Nobody was talking about how could I start investing right now and how can I go ahead and put my money into vehicles that's going to go ahead and make money for me without me having to do any work. For a lot of people, sitting money in a savings account is literally the most everybody does when it comes to anything with money when you want to go ahead and put it away. But the problem that we always hear about with that is the fact that a bank account doesn't really pay any interest on your money when it comes to sitting it in a saving account. And then we love to talk about inflation, especially during a time right now. You're literally losing money to inflation every single day you sit your money in a bank account without actually allowing that money to do something to make yourself money back in return. Of course, investing takes research and understanding what you actually are interested in investing in. Because if you don't understand something and it doesn't feel comfortable, then you don't want to put your money there anyway. But studying and finding what works for you and what fits your personality and what you're interested in is so important to investing successfully for the long term. So make sure y'all go ahead and do your research on whatever you decide you want to invest in, but understand that there's risk involved with any investment we're going to make. You can lose money in anything that you invest in. So you got to be aware that you can afford to lose money that you're investing. I always say, don't go ahead and invest your rent money expecting to make a crazy return super fast, and then you end up losing money and you can't pay your rent. Unless that's what you're into, it's your money. You do what you gotta do. It's just not something I'm interested in. The second money mistake that everybody in their 20s needs to avoid right now is renting expensive apartments. Now, I live in California, and a lot of people already know what the prices is looking like when it comes to these apartments in California. But even in California, there's ways to avoid renting apartments that's super expensive and you can't afford, or it's just something that leaves you no room to go ahead and do anything else with your money at all because everything is going to your rent. Like living in LA, that's obviously one of the most expensive parts in California that you can live in, or maybe if you even got a roommate. And in the investing world, when we talk about real estate, a lot of people like to go the duplex route because you can go ahead and buy a property that has two units on the property, and then you can go ahead and live in one and rent out the other and have a tenant pay majority or all of your mortgage every single month, so that you pay little to no money every single month to go ahead and live in your house. Even going ahead and living with your parents for even longer so that you can put yourself in a position to where you can actually afford these more expensive spots when the time is right. There's a lot of ways to go ahead and avoid renting expensive apartments, but we just got to go ahead and put our ego to the side and do what we got to do in order to get to that level that we can actually afford it. And we're not just doing it because the world says we should, or the world says we should move out of our parents' house at a certain time. You got to do what's right for yourself. Don't worry about anybody else. And you're definitely going to avoid making that money mistake. Now, the third money mistake is buying expensive cars. This is another thing when it comes to ego. When we start to get older, we think that we need a certain car to look good for people around us, whether it's for social media or our friends or whoever, to maybe feel like we're further ahead in life, or just to do the things that we think we should be doing at a certain age. But you see a lot of people buying cars that they can't really afford just to look good, and it doesn't make any sense. Just like with the renting apartments, you have to make sure whatever you're doing actually works for yourself, and you can't take anybody else's judgment or anything into consideration when it comes to making these types of decisions. Buying expensive cars is only going to hold you back, and it's going to put you in a position where you're going to regret it. And also for entrepreneurs, when we're thinking about investing or starting a business and we're working our 9-to-5 to pay these high car payments or these high rents, that's something that you could be investing into yourself and your business to go ahead and grow and make more money, and then you could go ahead and afford those things that you want. But right now we want to be in go mode so we can continue to elevate our income. We can invest and we can afford these apartments and we can afford these cars, houses, whatever it is. So if we do want to go ahead and get these cars, we're not stressed out about it, and we don't feel trapped to a certain job or doing anything that we don't want to do at all for the rest of our lives. Now, the fourth money mistake is spending too much money. Like I was saying in the beginning of this video, when we get older, we start thinking about things that we ain't think about when we was kids. Like maybe Maybe you're going on expensive dates and you eating out all the time because you got money for the first time in your life. When you was a kid, you didn't have any money unless your parents gave it to you. And it's easy to not be conscious of how much money you have coming in and how much money you actually spending every single month. Now, in this video right here, I went ahead and talked about budgeting and how beneficial it is and how it actually helps you understand how much more money you actually making and how much more money you actually have when you actually get to see it on paper and you actually know how much you making and how much you spending and exactly what you need to pay every single month, and you actually get a visual of your finances instead of just freestyling everything and then wondering where the money went when you don't have any money. Maybe you're going on vacations that you can't afford. Now, we all want to travel and we all want to do the things that we want. We all want to go out and eat as much, and I'm all for it. I'm not one of them people that says you completely have to not do anything and don't have any fun, but you want to know exactly what it is you have going on financially so that when you do these things, you don't have to feel guilty or you don't have to be scared to look at your bank account. We all know what that feel like. Or you're not maxing out your credit cards and you don't have the money. These are things that we want to avoid. And that's why I'm dropping this video right here, so that y'all can avoid these money mistakes that I made or people around me that I was able to learn from as well. Now, with all that being said, if you avoid these four money mistakes in your 20s, you're going to be setting yourself up for a way better future. You're going to have more knowledge when it comes to money, and you can go ahead and help people around you as well, so that you don't have to be stressed when it comes to money. And when you talk about money, it's actually an enjoyable experience. You're not constantly thinking about your pockets because you understand what's going on. Y'all go ahead and comment down below the money mistake that's been holding you back and how you gonna go ahead and adjust going forward so that's no longer a problem for you in your life. If you need more insight on how to make more money or how to avoid making money mistakes that keep a lot of people broke, make sure y'all go ahead and check out this playlist right here. Let's get rich.
He got an alibi and he won't abide to no law. I know it's fucked up, but he won't hesitate to go send a nigga to a law. Young nigga with rag ties in the back of a Maybach. Put in work, whole fam gon' eat. I've been going to work on E, all grind, no sleep, I stay low key. And you know I be rolling with killers, they really gorillas. Only the realest, you know that we winning. I feel like I.